Good morning and welcome. Our opening hymn this morning will be Sing with All the Saints in Glory.
Same time, we offer this Mass for all of your own intentions, your own special needs, that God, through our prayer today, will touch your hearts with his peace and comfort. And so let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of God our Father, the love of Jesus Christ, and the friendship and peace of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as the Lord's family to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us first now call to mind our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and in the glory of God. Let us all pray. May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of the resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying here in Jerusalem, let this be known to you. Listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus, the Nazarene, was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too shall dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the nether world, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.' My brothers, one can confidently say to you about that patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this very day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, David foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the nether world, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he received the promise of the Holy Spirit from his Father, and has poured the Spirit forth as you see, and now hear." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially according to each one's work, then conduct yourselves with reverence during this time of your temporary dwelling here, realizing that you were ransomed from the futile conduct handed on by your ancestors. Not ransomed with perishable things like silver or gold, but rather with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in these final days for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With that, their eyes were opened and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us? So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, the Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon. Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Of all the appearances of the risen Christ recorded in the scriptures, none has a stronger hold on the hearts of Christians than the ones that we have just heard proclaimed in today's gospel. This is a story. No, wait. It's more than a story. You might call this one of the wonderful teachings of our faith. It's one that has brought hope and comfort to many broken hearts and broken spirits. And when you think about it, it has everything to do with your life and mine. What makes it so practical is this insight. In the midst of gloom and doom, in the midst of all the sorrows that we face in life, we often tend to focus so much on ourselves that we miss the fact that we are still walking with Jesus, and Jesus is still walking with us. Luke tells us in this resurrection story, he places it in the context of a journey from Jerusalem to Emmaus. And two friends, one of whom is named Cleopas, are disciples of Jesus. We really don't know who these two are. They follow Jesus through his crushing death and his apparent defeat on Friday. And it certainly crushed them and all of their hopes, all of their dreams, all of their aspirations. They were, sad to say, at the deepest and most desperate hour in their lives. Never in a million years would they ever have imagined that it would have come to this terrible ending. On that Friday, they must have moved around as if they were almost in a trance, like family members or close friends of any person who suddenly dies or tragically passes away. Their lives are now in a tailspin, and the gospel tells us that they're downcast. What a mild word to use for people whose lives have been devastated. All their hopes were in Jesus. Everything that they had dreamed of died with Jesus on that horrific Friday. There was nothing left for them in Jerusalem, or so they thought. So they headed to Emmaus. Where was Emmaus? Luke tells us that it was a small village about 7 miles from Jerusalem. And that's all we know. But that doesn't matter. Perhaps Emmaus was the hometown of one of these disciples. We can only guess that. It may have been the first stop in the long walk home from Jerusalem for these two. Perhaps the first place with an inn to rest for the night before taking up the arduous journey the next day. Perhaps it may have been the place where they heard there might be work, or perhaps the place where they were hoping to get their former jobs back. What was it left for them to do? Maybe they were heading to Emmaus simply because they had to get away from it all. They simply wanted to escape. Maybe Emmaus was their place to go when hope dies, when pain is too great to endure, and when even faith cannot imagine a new future with new beginnings. And into this sad scenario, a stranger appears, a man whom they do not recognize, and in their conversation, and finally in the breaking of the bread, they realize that it is Jesus Christ, truly alive, just as the women had told them. Their immense sorrow is turned to incredible joy, and they head back now to Jerusalem to join the other disciples to share in that good news. I'm sure all of us have experienced the dark times in our lives, times when we don't know where to turn or what to do. And I'm sure that there have been times when all of us have needed our own place to escape to, some place to get away for a while, just to get our minds cleared and set right. We all need our own place called Emmaus. For some, perhaps Emmaus is a cottage by the shore. For others, a trip to the mall, or perhaps my favorite, a dozen cannolis eaten behind a locked bedroom door. For others, perhaps, it's the quiet in a church. Emmaus can be that place we run to when life deals us more pain than we can ever possibly bear. Everyone has an Emmaus. What or where is yours? We can be like these two disciples, so caught up in our own sorrow and burdens, we miss the fact that Christ is truly walking with us. Remember, Emmaus is also a place where Christ can speak most powerfully to our hearts. And so if you are carrying heavy burdens, you feel alone, perhaps you're in grief, lost or in despair, if the coronavirus and the quarantine has led you to depression or loneliness and fear, remember, the Lord Jesus is closer to you than you can ever imagine. Let us together now profess our common faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth,
and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our Savior was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
Jesus appeared to his disciples on the road to Emmaus and promised to walk with them. In complete trust and confidence, we place before him all of our prayers and needs.
For the church, that like the early disciples, may we too recognize Jesus in our midst and follow him with sincere hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for an end to the COVID-19 pandemic across the globe, and for healing and consolation of all those who have been affected by the virus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who hold public office, that they may empathize with those with whom they serve, especially the weak and the vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all first responders, for members of the armed forces, for all healthcare professionals, and all who risk their own lives for the protection of others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill and suffer in mind, body, or spirit, may God grant them healing, strength, and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who have died, may they follow Jesus, the risen Lord, into the kingdom of light and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the prayers that we now offer in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of goodness and peace, you summon us to follow your Son. Hear the prayers we place before you and those we hold in the silence of our hearts. Ease our pains and doubts, and call us to trust in Jesus, for he is Lord, now and forever. Amen.
Joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise,
and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they now acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them now to rejoice in the light of your presence, and in the resurrection give to them the fullness of life and joy. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and the martyrs and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Thank you.
Let us all pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you abundantly, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God.